Spokes, sprockets, hollow tubes of steel, they are the base elements of design ingenuity.
We had to make an ultra low cost, super robust, very simple mobility aid that didn't exist before. We essentially had to reinvent the wheelchair.
Yes, it is a wheelchair, but to people with disabilities in the developing world, it is much more than that. It is a pathway to making a living, it is freedom. And according to its designer, it fills a huge need in the developing world.
The estimates are about 40 to 60 million people who need a wheelchair but don't have one, and about 70% of those people live in rural areas.
Dr. Amos Winter is a professor of mechanical engineering at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in Cambridge, Massachusetts. He runs the Global Engineering and Research Lab. Winter and his team came up with the idea for the Leverage Freedom Chair after spending time in Tanzania. He noticed that people with disabilities there had an especially hard time getting around.
If you live out in a village, there was no single product that would enable you to travel long distances on rough terrain, but also be small enough to use in the home.
Winter's goal was to create a wheelchair that could handle all sorts of terrain, could be built cheaply, and very important, could be repaired easily using readily accessible parts. And so the Leverage Freedom Chair was born. Built primarily of bicycle parts, it has a gearbox controlled by the ultimate in manual transmissions, human hands.
If you grab high on the levers, that gives you an effective low gear, so you can pump your way through sand or mud or up a steep hill. And as you slide your hands down the levers, you can push through a big angle every stroke, and that makes the chair go very quickly.
And therein lies the genius. Even though the LFC technically has just one gear, it becomes in essence a three-speed chair simply by having the user adjust the position of his hands.
This chair can go about 80% faster than a normal wheelchair on the street and produce 50% more peak pushing force.
The Leverage Freedom Chair is now in production in India, a place from which it can be easily and cheaply shipped to countries that most need it. But Winter developed a new Built in America version after learning people with disabilities in the U.S. wanted a more robust chair too. The Freedom Chair is very similar to Winter's original design, but
we had to add additional features like making it collapsible so it could fit in the trunk of a small car.
Still, Winter continues to focus his design work on developing countries. It is a huge challenge.
You're pushing new technology that meets or exceeds the performance of what we have in this country, but at a tenth to a thousandth the price.
Dr. Winter's world is one of machines and raw materials and complicated ideas made concrete. The Leverage Freedom Chair, he suggests, is just the beginning.
You have billions of people that face challenges that are often life or death in nature. They have a technical aspect to them, and nobody knows how to solve those challenges. What better foundation for research could you ask for?
In Cambridge, Massachusetts, Jim Morelli for CNN.